my understanding is that Sergey Brin is, like, he views himself completely as American because he has kids that are American. He thinks this is messed up. He thinks the First Amendment and a lot of the amendments don't matter at all to these, to the dictatorship of the Harvard Law School, the people that are in charge of American laws. All right, so I mentioned central bank issued cryptocurrency. What's the difference between a central bank issued cryptocurrency and a regular cryptocurrency? It's that I can add liquidity if I want to, or the central bank can add liquidity. So whereas the price of cryptocurrency can skyrocket based on demand and based on usage and based on scarcity, especially during like a period like the halving, where the miners, which basically what happens when you make cryptocurrency is that you have rooms full of computers that are basically made, like they're designed specifically for cracking codes for, or for making hashes. And it's kind of like I have this gaming computer that has like certain types of things that help it go faster. Cryptocurrency needs those type of computers. And so if I have a central bank issued cryptocurrency, I don't have to have the same type of servers. I don't have to chug all the time to produce more money. I don't have to use electricity to produce money because my server is going to issue money whenever it wants. It doesn't have to work for it. And I understand that's a complicated issue, but I feel like it's almost unsafe for a country as big as the United States not to be able to inject liquidity because you don't understand what can happen with new technologies or with just a changing society. That's why we had to go off the gold standard. Also, I don't know, I think that was good for the American stockpile of gold. I've talked about it in the past. We have gold. We have the Roman Empire's gold. We have Chinese gold. We have Japanese gold. We have Egyptian gold, like the ancient Egyptians. If you go to the Egyptian Museum, it's not that much gold. It's mainly stone carvings. Who else's gold do we have? Israel's gold. Yeah, we have Israel's gold, I think, unless Israel has it. I don't know. I think we have it. But Israel has a lot of gold too. But also, there's the modern gold trade to this day that goes on because there are mines that are still pumping out more gold than ever because of new technology. So let's not doubt that other people have gold also. I don't think people understand the role that we play in the world economy. And they don't really understand because we kind of sit out a lot. Just because I sit out doesn't mean that I can't just take all my offshore dollars and trade it to someone at a very nice exchange rate. And that's what I don't think people understand about like messing with a guy who, I don't even launder money. I've constantly told you guys, like, I don't do this for myself. I do this because I freaking have to, because I think that the American economy will collapse and then everyone will blame me. But then apparently they're going to blame me this time. Even though it's the cops' fault, but I guess it's both of our faults.